It's AumSum time.
What if year 2017 disappeared?
Oh no! 17 is my favorite number!
Ooh, AumSum.
To buy this sweatshirt, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, collision of two neutron stars was confirmed as the source of heavy elements like gold, platinum, etc. If 2017 disappeared, scientists would be one sad lot. Secondly, Wonder Woman, a superhero film, was released in 2017. If 2017 disappeared, movie buffs would be one sad lot. Thirdly, SpaceX made history by launching and landing a used rocket. If 2017 disappeared, space fans would be one sad lot. Lastly, IOC awarded 2024 Olympics to Paris and 2028 Olympics to Los Angeles. If 2017 disappeared, citizens of Paris as well as Los Angeles would be one sad lot. Are earphones harmful?
No, they make us look cool.
Oh, listen. When any sound wave enters our ear, it creates vibrations in our eardrum. These vibrations then travel through tiny bones and eventually get transmitted to cochlea. Cochlea is a fluid-filled chamber with tiny hair cells. Now these vibrations move the fluid as well as the hair cells, allowing us to hear. Now, as earphones are very close to our eardrums, continuous loud music causes extreme movement of the hair cells, thus decreasing their sensitivity over time, eventually leading to hearing loss. Now, some solutions. Firstly, we can hear better quality music at a lower volume level with noise-canceling earphones as they remove unwanted background sounds. Secondly, some experts recommend the 60x60 rule. One should listen to music at 60% volume for a maximum of 60 minutes. Thirdly, over-the-ear headphones are recommended as they are further away from our eardrums. Are canned foods safe?
No, just pizzas are safe.
Oh, AumSum. Canning is basically a method in which food items are processed and then packed in airtight containers. This helps preserve food for longer periods. However, there are some disadvantages of canned foods. Firstly, canned foods can be high in sugar and salt, so they can pose a risk for people with high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, etc. Secondly, most cans have a coating of bisphenol A to prevent corrosion. Studies suggest that bisphenol A can leak into the food and have negative effects on our hormones and reproductive system. Thirdly, the acids present in food can react with the metal can and produce hydrogen gas, creating bulges, thus making food unsafe to eat. Lastly, improper canning process can lead to growth of dangerous bacteria called Clostridium botulinum. It produces a lethal toxin which, if consumed, can paralyze our muscles and cause death if left untreated. Is expired food safe to eat?
No problemo. I'm as strong as Hulk.
Oh, AumSum. Usually we see three types of dates on food products. Sell by, best by, and use by. Use by is what we call the expiry date. Consuming food past this date may prove to be harmful. Firstly, the nutritional value of the food will reduce. Secondly, as bacteria don't usually grow at low temperatures, many foods are frozen. But if foods are kept at room temperature, bacteria will develop in them. Now, if consumed, they can cause vomiting, diarrhea, food poisoning, etc. Thirdly, it is believed that when canned food expires, the acids present in food react with the metal can and produce hydrogen gas, creating bulges in the can and thus making the food unsafe to eat. So, expiry date is definitely a good indicator. But apart from that, we should also rely on our senses of smell and sight to check the quality of the food. What if Jupiter never existed?
No problem. I will give company to Saturn, Jupiter's lonely neighbor.
Oh, AumSum. As per Roman mythology, Jupiter is the god of thunder, lightning, and storms. It is the largest planet in our solar system, and its mass is about 2.5 times the total combined weight of all the other planets in our solar system. Now, if Jupiter would have never existed, it is safe to say that even we would not have existed. Why? Because some scientists believe that during the initial stages of the formation of our solar system, Jupiter's inward migration towards the Sun and then subsequent outward migration away from the Sun and towards Saturn played a vital role in the formation of Mercury, Venus, and Earth. Also, since ages, Jupiter has been protecting Earth from collisions with large asteroids and comets. Lastly, more than 70 moons of Jupiter would have wandered along the solar system as orphans. Is too much salt bad for us?
No. Too many questions are bad for us.
Oh, Some. Salt is basically sodium chloride. It is important for various bodily functions such as transmitting nerve impulses, digestion, etc. However, too much of something is never good. Firstly, when too much salt enters our blood, the water content in our blood rises, increasing the volume of blood. As a result, our heart works harder than usual. Secondly, as more blood flows through the blood vessels, it puts strain on their walls. Over time, this causes the walls to grow thicker, narrowing the vessels and thus increasing our blood pressure. In addition to this, narrowing of blood vessels means less oxygen and nutrients get transported to the cells, increasing the risk of dementia, stroke, and heart attacks. Lastly, to remove excess salt, our kidneys use more water and we urinate more frequently, thus leaving us dehydrated and thirsty. What if we breathe only by mouth?
Nah, I only lick lollipops using my mouth.
Oh, Some. Breathing by nose has a number of advantages. Firstly, hair and mucus in our nose help in filtering out foreign materials, dust, allergens, etc. Secondly, nose breathing releases more nitric oxide, which is ultimately responsible for more release of oxygen. Lastly, nose adds warmth and moisture to inhaled air. This makes it more suitable for our respiratory tract. Breathing by mouth has the following disadvantages. Firstly, breathing by mouth dries up our saliva. As there is very less saliva, it is unable to protect us against harmful pathogens. Secondly, in children, continuous mouth breathing may lead to crooked teeth or minor jaw deformities. Thirdly, experts believe that mouth breathing can lead to lack of oxygen in our body. Lastly, mouth breathing also leads to sleep apnea. Sleep apnea results in sleep deprivation, which causes fatigue and exhaustion. What is BMI?
Burger with mango ice cream.
Nah. BMI stands for Body Mass Index. It is used to check whether we have a healthy weight according to our height. BMI is calculated by dividing a person's weight in kilograms with his height in meters squared. A BMI of 18.49 or below indicates that the person is underweight. 18.5 to 24.99 is considered as normal weight. 25 to 29.99 overweight, and a BMI of 30 or more is considered as obese. Thus, BMI helps doctors to categorize our overall health. However, some experts think that this method is not accurate. Why? Because BMI doesn't distinguish between fat and muscle mass. So, for example, if a person has more well-defined muscle mass and less fat levels, BMI will categorize him as obese. Also, a person having less muscle mass and more amount of harmful visceral fat may be considered healthy by BMI. Lastly, BMI doesn't even take into account an individual's age, gender, etc. What if you fall into quicksand?
No problem. I am quicker than quicksand.
Oh, Some. Quicksand is a waterlogged mixture of sand, clay, and salt. It is a non-Newtonian fluid. That is, it changes its thickness or viscosity depending on the stress applied on it. So, an undisturbed quicksand appears and acts like a solid. But when we step on it, our weight increases the stress. Hence, it starts behaving like a liquid, thus causing us to sink. However, we will not fully sink into quicksand. Why? Firstly, because quicksand is usually not very deep. Secondly, it is believed that quicksand is a bit denser than humans. So what? In an experiment, experts prepared aluminum beads which had similar density as humans. When they placed those beads in quicksand and moved them to mimic the action of a panicked human, the beads sank, but only halfway, thus indicating that we will not completely sink in quicksand.